Hey folks, how you doing? Don Grandt, CTC Cutting Tool Counselor, here with another exciting episode of In the Loupe TV, sponsored by Harvey Performance Company. I know it's been a while, don't get mad at me. I got other jobs too, you know, this is not my only job, okay? But we're all busy. So this one's gonna be an exciting one. Thanks for being patient, thanks for waiting. But we were talking about surfacing on the last three episodes with the ball nose end mill. Now we wanna get into five axis stuff, and this one's gonna be exciting because we're gonna just talk about something called circle segment machining, where we have tools called HMAF cutters, helical multi-axis finishers. These are tools that look something like this, right? You're probably looking at those going, I've seen those, but never really understood how to use them. Well, guess what? Today is your lucky day. I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about these tools, what's their meaning, how they benefit you, and how they can reduce your cycle time, give you a better finish and surfacing, and a whole bunch of other stuff with that. So please, come back, stick around, watch this episode, because we're going to talk about it next. Well, hey folks, thanks for coming back. Enjoy it. I really want to dive into something called circle segment machining, which uses tools that everybody calls something a little bit different. Some of them are called conical cutters. Some companies actually call them circle segment cutters. We call them HMAFs, helical multi-axis finishers. Key multi-axis there. Some people even know them as barrel cutters, even though barrel cutter is actually a definition of one of the shapes. We'll get into it a little bit later. But they seem very misunderstood. I go to a lot of shops. I have a lot of questions all the time. There's areas in machining that I see all the time where we should be using these type of tools. I'm going to explain that to you, but we can't do it here. We have to run to the shop and talk about it next. Well, hey folks, thanks for coming back to the shop. I really appreciate it. So we are talking about something called HMAF cutters, or as everybody knows them, circle segment cutters. If you don't mind, I'm just going to refer to them as HMAF cutters for this episode, just because we call them HMAF cutters, helical multi-axis finishers, which key multi-axis finishers, multi-axis, these are multi-axis tooling. We're going to understand it. But before we get to that, we need to understand a ball nose a little bit better. If we're doing surfacing with a ball nose, we know our scallop height controls our surface, right? And when we have a quarter inch ball nose, the only thing we get to use to create that scallop height to give us our finish is a quarter inch. Now, if we want that surface to get a little bit better and we want to run a little bit faster, we have to jump up in radius size so we can keep the scallop height the same. So a quarter inch, a half inch is going to give us a better finish. And if a half inch gives us a better finish because we can step over greater and still achieve the same surface height, you know, scallop height, then maybe a 1 inch is a little bit better. And then if we go from a 1 inch, a 2 inch might be a little bit better. Well, wouldn't it be good to get the benefits of like a 36 inch end mill? Jeez. Well, might need a reduced shank on that one. Nah, it's a joke. It's a joke. It's not really a 36. Nobody makes a 36 inch end mill. But wouldn't it be great to get the benefits of a 36 inch radius? We're going to talk about it. Okay. Okay, folks. Let's talk about a HMAF cutter and a larger radius and how we achieve that and what the benefits are of that. Let's take a look at, we were talking on the last one about a 36 inch diameter tool. Let's take a look at that. All right. Let's look at a 36 inch diameter circle. If we take that 36 diameter circle and we start just taking it down to a small segment of that 36 diameter, 36 inches, look at now, I can take that little segment of that radius and I can put it on a half inch diameter cutting tool. Segment of a radius, of a circle, a circle segment of a larger radius. That's what these tools are. Is what we're doing is taking a segment of a circle and we are putting it on the end of a smaller tool. This way, we get the benefits of that big radius that we were talking about, right? Our scallop height is minimized by a maximum step over, and we can actually use that segment in a five-axis machine. Now, don't get ahead of me, okay? Because there's ways to use that. But now let's talk about the benefits of how that segment of a circle, or now that I got 36 inches of a radius on there, how I can use that and how that's going to benefit me at my spindle when I'm doing surfacing. So folks, let's just look at the benefit of this. This is pretty obviously right because we're going from a smaller diameter ball nose to a larger radius. So if we just put these side by side, you can see if we just use a ball nose and we start cutting those scallops in order to get a better finish, and you do get achieve a better finish, and in order to run a lot faster, we can go a lot quicker, a lot further down. So if you look at a 36 inch diameter that we've been talking about, and trust me, they start at 3, 4, 5 inches and they go all the way up to sometimes 50 inches in diameter. And we run that down, you can be 8, 10, you know, six times greater than what you would do with a ball nose, which means if you wanted to get your scallop height and your scallop height was X and you had to do a 10 thou step over, 8 times you could use a circle segment and you could go 80 thou versus 10 thou. So it's an 80 thou advantage over 10, 8 times. So these are very useful. They're a lot faster and you can save a lot of time when you use these. The key in understanding how to use these is looking at the right applications to put them in. And that's where we kind of come in to help you out a little bit better with that. Okay, folks. Now that you kind of know that these are segments of a circle and they're used to do surfacing, let's talk a little bit more about these tools. Let's look at them. Let's look at them one at a time. Let's just talk about them really quick. So the first one that I like that gives you the biggest bang for your buck is a taper form. Taper form. So this means it comes in a variety of tapers on the bottom. It has the largest radius on the bottom. It's going to give you the biggest multiplier for helping your surfacing on the bottom. And this, on our end, comes in a variety of angles. It comes in 15 degrees or 30 degrees included. It comes 30 degrees or 60 degrees included, 45 degrees or 90 degrees included. It comes in 60 degrees or 120 degrees included. And the final one is 75 degrees or 150 degrees included. I knew it. I know you thought I didn't know it. It's 150 degrees included. So it's flatter to steeper. There's a reason for that. That's in another episode, but those are the taper angles, which gives you the biggest bang for the buck. If you look at these tools, you'll also notice it's not only one taper or one big radius on the face. There is a full ball on the bottom and a radius on the top for blending. And we're going to explain how to use those a little bit more when we get into the programming section of these. Yes, spoiler alert. I am going really deep into these tools. On the next one, I'm going to show you how to program these. I think that's a fear for a lot of people. So let's jump to the next one. Oval form, one of my favorites. Really good size radius, good benefit. So you see here, again, a big segment of a radius that you can use in your programming and your application. Not as great as the radius that's in the taper form, but a different shape. Radius on the top and a full ball on the bottom. Ball nose on the bottom, still have that ball nose, so you can use that ball nose for other things. Next form we're gonna go with is a lens form. A lens form, take a look at this one. Anybody wanna guess what you use a lens form for? Yeah, a little bit more on the bottom. Surfacing on the bottom of a plate. You got some wibbly wobs? That's what we call it, technical. That's a technical phrase. You got some wibbly wobs on the bottom. You want to do some surfacing on the bottom where you're using a ball nose and you're actually hitting that with a ball nose and having those small step overs. Now we have a bigger radius on the bottom of a tool and you can hit that a lot faster, get those benefits, because your step overs to get the surface finish that's required on your print is going to be a lot better. And you can fit them into your holders. So the last one, and we at this point don't have this one in our catalog, is the barrel form. That's probably what you've heard a lot of, barrel form cutter. And if you look at this, it looks just like a barrel form. Again, all of these have the segment of a circle in a different shape so you can use it in replace of a ball nose end mill. Every ball nose situation that you're using, can you use one of these circle segment cutters, HMAF cutters? Can you use one of these in that application? Absolutely not. I just want to stress that because it's very important to understand when to use these, which we're going to dive into and have you understand that a little bit more. But that's each one of these shapes. As you can see, every one of these shapes has a segment of a circle, different diameters, different radiuses that are on there, and different shapes so you can use them in your applications and get the benefit multipliers that you need at your spindle. Folks, the big thing here with these tools is you have different shapes, right? You have different radiuses or segments of a circle that have to be manipulated in your tool path or your software, your CAM software that you're using, in order to put that radius where you need it in order to maximize your surface. This is where the five axis comes in. This is where it's very important to use these tools in a five axis situation. Because in order to take a shape that looks like this and get that radius in the right spot everywhere you need it in your part, you need some five axis manipulation or tool tilt, which we all know of. And this is really important with these tools. That's why the next episode that I'll be launching really quick, we're going to take a look at these tools. I'm going to pull out some of my programming experience. There's a little collaboration here that I want to give a spoiler on with MasterCam. Thank you to MasterCam to help me with a couple things. There's going to be a lot of tips, and I want to take the fear out of everybody putting these in their spindle and using them in their tool path and show you how easy it is really to program these tools if you have a five-axis machine. And I'll tell you what, if you don't have a five-axis machine with these tools, after you watch this video, I think you're going to be thinking about maybe getting one in the shop, because you're going to see some huge benefits from using these tools in your application. So folks, the key to these tools, just to give you the benefits of them, which way outweigh a ball nose, is faster, better surface finish. Not that hard to program. They're not that difficult to program. You're gonna see the benefits right away. And I'll tell you what, if you're stuck in the world of using a ball nose and you do not look at every ball nose situation and surfacing that you're in your shop and start looking at these multi-axis finishing tools, circle segment cutters, conical cutters, call them what you want, huge radius cutters, anything. If you're not looking at these when you have a ball nose situation in a five-axis machine, you might get left behind. We can help with that. But besides that, thanks for watching. Always appreciate it. And if you like this video, I would also appreciate a like and subscribe. That would be really nice and fine and dandy. Other than that, three guarantees in life, folks: death, taxes, and spring passes. Have a great rest of your week.